everybody, and welcome back to Block Talk and another episode of Behavior Solutions. Today's topic is going to be height dominance, and we're going to go over all the different ways you can address this problem. I initially wasn't going to actually cover this topic for another couple months, but we got a comment recently telling me not to have my birds on my shoulder because they are going to start to dominate me. So I figured I would address that problem now and nip that right in the bud. So to start off, I'm going to go ahead and tell you that parrots are not a dominating species. There are very few animals that do have that sort of hierarchy and actually exhibit those behaviors, and parrots are not one of them. Most parrots are flock species or they work in pairings. There is no benefit to them to have one major leader to bully and influence the others. It does not benefit the flock system in any sort of way. That's not how birds function. That's not how they learn. That's not how they navigate the world. So your bird is not going to try to dominate you. For those of you who do not know, height dominance is when a bird is put on your shoulder height or higher. They could be up on things in a system like this, or anywhere where they are above your eye level, they are going to try to dominate you, present a lot of aggressive behavior in order to do what lots of folks like to call dominance. As you can tell by my excessive use of air quotes, this is not the case when it comes to parrots. It is absolutely true that you can get aggressive behavior when birds are up high, but dominance is not what's at play here.
Where are you going?
As you can clearly tell, my birds are hippity-hopping all over my shoulder. They are happy and as peaceful as could be. Nobody's getting angry or grumpy or aggressive. They can go up on my head and nobody is going to fight me or have issues getting off of my head. Dominance is not an issue here. The birds don't think I'm more dominant than them. There is no dominance in this household. It does not exist in this context. The whole reason why this came about is from outdated logics in dog training, in which people think you need to dominate the dog in your household in order to get them to do what you want. This is another misunderstanding, which is not totally related to what we're talking about today, so I'm going to leave that. But when it comes to parrots, that sort of mentality accidentally got transferred over when people started keeping them as pets, and just sort of applied those outdated ideologies into parrot training as well. And they started having behaviors that occurred where a bird would be more aggressive up high, and they just assumed that it must be dominance and had it be so without actually doing any studies to figure out what was going on. Through more recent research, we can establish that this is not the way that parrots work, that they do not use dominance in a daily regular basis. While they may bicker over resources and present aggressions for different reasons, they are not trying to dominate one another to become some sort of leader of the flock and have some sort of rule over the entire system. Birds very much rely on one another to guide and traverse their world, and if one bird was in charge of everything, there would be a lot of problems. If you're completely relying on one bird to notice when there's a predator and make choices, you're going to get eaten, your entire flock is going to suffer, whereas if you have thousands of little birdie eyes in your little flock keeping an eye out and navigating the world, you're going to have a lot more success, you're all going to survive a lot more, you're going to have a lot quicker response times, you're going to be successful. For that reason, dominance doesn't work all too well in the parrot world, so they don't use it. So what is really happening when your bird goes above your eye level and starts presenting aggressive behavior? Since dominance is not at play here, but something has to be, right? They wouldn't just be getting aggressive for absolutely no reason. The simplest answer for this is usually fear. 9 times out of 10, a bird is going up high because they want to get away from you, something is scaring them, they're finding something threatening, and birds find safety in height. Going up somewhere high, flying up on a high perch, up on top of your fridge, going on top of your head, above your shoulders, anywhere that's not near your hands, that have a tendency to grab them, that have negative associations, getting away from those things, going up high, gives them safety. And what they're gonna do if the thing that they're afraid of, which might be your hands, it might just be you, starts coming towards them and impeding that safety, is your bird's gonna present an aggressive response to tell you to go away. Odds are there's been other body language cues before this to tell you that the bird is uncomfortable, they maybe walked away a little bit, widened their eyes, they might have stood up really tall, the bird might have actually fluffed up and gotten down low. There has been a ton of other tiny little body language cues that your bird has given you to say, hey, I am uncomfortable with what is happening. I do not feel safe here. I need you to go away. When you ignore those body language cues, your bird will progress more and more so towards the aggressive side of things until they have to fight you. That will be why your bird is coming to the conclusion that going up high means that they're having to present these aggressive responses to get you to go away. This is not your bird trying to dominate you and say that they are better than you. This is your bird simply feeling scared or threatened and telling you to back off and give them space. There are 3 main instincts when it comes to avoiding things that are scary. There's fight, there's flight, and there's freezing. A bird's most common instinct will be to freeze or to fly away. They aren't exactly equipped for fighting. They don't do very well with it. They are very, very vulnerable. They are very fragile. If they don't have to fight, then they won't. Your bird will likely see a threat and either rapidly decide whether it is beneficial to stay totally still and hope that the threat doesn't see them, or to fly away and hopefully avoid the situation altogether. 9 times out of 10, that's the option that your bird has chosen that has put them up in this very, very high, hard to reach location. Your bird goes up high to fly away from the threatening situation. They have already tried. Flight is that option to escape. And now you are impeding that space, trying to get them down, forcing them into situations, and they cannot escape anymore. They've tried that option, it didn't work, so they're having to switch to fight. And that is where the aggressive behavior is starting to display. The bird is starting to tell you to go away, they might be trying to lunge at you, and whatever else is going on. There are a few other things that could be happening when your bird presents aggressive behavior on your shoulders and higher. Things like hormonal influences, the season that it is, and all those breeding hormones could absolutely instigate more aggressive behavior. You may also be having a situation where your bird is resource guarding something, where they don't feel like they have enough food and they feel the need to protect it. They may also be very protective of a particular person, so they're sitting on your shoulder, getting very nesty and comfortable, and then feeling the need to protect that, so they lunge out and bite whatever's closest to them. There are a few other elements that couldn't be influencing behavior, but in general, when your bird goes up somewhere high and then starts getting aggressive, it's mostly because they are scared. Absolutely evaluate your situation. If your bird doesn't have a tendency to do this and it's come out of nowhere, or they aren't presenting any sort of fear body language prior, then you can start to evaluate that it might be due to some other cause, and would absolutely encourage you to break down the behavior, figure out what the antisense are, figure out what things are happening right before the behavior happens that might be causing it to occur. From there, you can kind of rearrange things, reevaluate, and come up with a proper training plan to address this problem. For the vast majority of you, your bird will be getting aggressive up high just because they're scared, so that's going to be the root that we address today. Going off the root of knowing that the bird is scared, they're feeling threatened, they're fearful, we can know how to address this a little bit better. Instead of trying to punish the bird, get angry at them, or quickly rip them down from their high safe point, we can address what has caused them fear and how to avoid it in the future. If your bird has flown away and is scared of you, you need to work on bonding exercises, do some recall practice, have fun with your bird and establish a good solid bond. Do a bunch of different fun training things, engage with them, help them feel safe and secure with you. So when your bird does end up going up high, they are very, very willing to come down and hang out with you. They don't see you as a threat. They don't think you're taking away fun things from them, and you're going to have a good time every time they come and engage with you. The more treats, the more scritches, the more fun chitter chatter you have with your bird, the more engaged they're going to be, the more eager they're going to want to be to participate with you. A big key point to remember is that being up high is safe, and safety is reinforcing. Having control over your environment, that reduction of stress, all of those factors are reinforcing. So wanting to go up high is something your bird is naturally reinforcing themselves to do. Your bird is going up high, that stress is being reduced, they're having a good time, they're gonna do it again. Because this behavior is naturally reinforcing and we do not want to stop our birds from being able to go up high and feel safe, we want them to be able to do so, but also cooperate and come back down, it is very important to do recall practice. Recall is very, very simple. It can look very complicated. It can look very, very cool and impressive when done properly, but it is not actually difficult to train. All you need is like the back of a chair, a perch, a cage, something your bird can stand on, you and some treats. Really, you can teach it with just those things. I do have a tutorial on how to teach recall that I did many, many years ago that still applies today. You can absolutely follow those guides and go ahead, do some recall practice and get your bird to a point where they have learned that flying to you is extremely beneficial. Doing that training and having a really reliable recall where your bird understands that flying to you is going to be fun, there's going to be treats, there's going to be loud noises and fun times, is going to create a situation where your bird understands, yes, I'm up high where I am having fun, but flying down to my human may be actually more fun, and they're going to be more encouraged to come down and engage with you when you ask them to. Practicing recalling from high locations is important as well. Instead of solely recalling them to get them down off of something, set it up intentionally. Have something up high, put them up there, ask them to come down. Don't always specifically recall them from high places, only when they've been trying to avoid something. Make sure that you're doing excess practice with this so your bird understands what to do and how to do it properly. Other key things to remember is that if your bird is consistently associating coming down with a high place to immediately having something bad happen, like going back into their cage, being yelled at, whatever it is, your bird's gonna be less likely to come down next time and more likely to present more aggressive behavior. So if you're recalling your bird down to put them in a cage every single day, they're gonna start avoiding your hand and not wanting to come down because they know they're gonna end up getting put into their cage and they don't want that to happen. So making sure that you are doing recall practice, that you're calling them down a little early, spending time with them, and then putting them in their cage later or having something else happen later is gonna help reinforce that behavior and make sure that your bird is willing and excited to come down over and over and over again. One last quick tidbit to address is going to be your reactions. A lot of these sort of aggressive behavior when it comes to sitting on shoulders specifically comes from the person and the way that the person is reacting. If Newt is on my shoulder here and he goes to nibble my earlobe or whatever, and I go, ah, and quickly pull my head away because I'm not super confident with birds or I haven't worked with them before, and I'm just not familiar with him, maybe I'm just not comfortable with him, he can find that really funny and reinforcing. My noises, my actions, my nervousness can all be something to encourage him to be a little bit more of a rascal every time he comes on me. If every time he nibbles my ear, it makes me do something he finds funny, it's going to encourage him to do it again. A lot of the time, your insecurities, your responses, all influence your bird's behavior. So when your bird is sitting on you and you find that they consistently bite your earlobe out of nowhere, or they are consistently doing something to hurt you out of nowhere, aggressive behavior just spurs out of nowhere, it is because you have accidentally reinforced it in the past. And the bird is doing it because they want you to have those responses again. They found it funny the first time, they're gonna find it funny again. So making sure that you are comfortable with your bird, that you are engaged with their behaviors, that you have a good understanding of when they're at being aggressive and when they're just playing around is very important, because you don't want to send the wrong message to your bird and you don't want to accidentally reinforce things you didn't intend to. With shoulders as well, another quick thing is going to be what is on you. Some birds can be very sensitive and irritable, especially if you have dangly earrings, things that make noise, or your hair is at this awkward length where it constantly catches on them and touches them. Those could absolutely be things that could agitate your bird and cause them to lash out and get aggressive. If you're sitting all fluffed up and comfy and half asleep and then all of a sudden an earring keeps hitting you in the face, or you keep wiggling your shoulder and being uncomfortable and causing them to be unbalanced, the bird may lash out and bite you because you keep moving, you keep disturbing them, it's not comfortable for them, they aren't happy. Those can all be reasons why a bird suddenly presents more aggressive behavior on you than anticipated. So in those sorts of situations, it's a matter of setting up the environment for success. If you know your bird is getting sleepy and they tend to get aggressive on your shoulder when they get sleepy, have a perch nearby that they can cuddle with, or maybe it's time to go into the cage and go to bed. Instead of letting them sit there and putting them into a situation where they're gonna get irritated by your things touching them or by your movements or your voice disturbing them, and then having that aggressive behavior occur anyways. Another simple exercise you can do to ensure that you are associating you coming near them at a high surface with positive associations is to simply give them treats when they are up somewhere high. Make sure that your bird knows that your hand coming towards them when they are up there is not something to be threatened by. If your bird is not able to fly for whatever reason, they will need to step up, and for a lot of birds, that can be very intimidating, having a big scary hand coming straight at them and cornering them against a wall when they're up on top of your cabinets. That can be very, very threatening. So I would make sure to do some exercises where you can have your bird up high in a nice open space and ask them to step up from very high places as well. So that way you're not having to have them only in this dire situation when they've been scared and flown away and now they have something coming at them and it's really scary and they don't know what to do. This way you have this background knowledge where you can have your bird stepping up from way above your head and already knowing that nothing bad is gonna come to them, that there's treats involved, that stepping up and engaging with your hands from a high space is absolutely beneficial. For this, I would start with just giving them treats while they're up somewhere high, put them on top of a cabinet or wherever you think they're gonna get stuck, and just put some treats down beside them, have the bird walk over and get them. They don't have to take them from you right away if they aren't comfortable doing so. And then you would just gradually do it where you put the treat down, have them waddle, leave your hand there, and then gradually work up to them taking the treats from your hand. and then you can move on to asking them to step up and things like that. That way the bird is getting more and more comfortable with the idea of your hand approaching them from a nice high space where they might find you potentially threatening. There are, of course, a million and one different reasons why aggressive behavior can occur, and if you are really stumped as to where it's happening or what it's coming from, I highly encourage you to seek out trainers in your area, to contact people. There are a lot of folks that you can send messages to and have them analyze your behavior and come up with a training plan for you. Without knowing exactly what is causing the root of that aggressive behavior, you cannot set up a successful training plan for it. However, I do hope that this has shed a little bit of light on the subject of height dominance and given you some tools that you can hopefully use to help your bird achieve great success. Just keep in mind that behavior is not personal. A bird is never lashing out and acting a certain way as a direct attack to you. They are not trying to do things to make you feel bad. They are not trying to manipulate you. They do not have the capacity to behave that way. A bird is simply behaving in response to a stimulus, and that is as simple as behavior is. But that's gonna do it for today's video, so thank you guys so much for watching. I hope this has helped, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye. Mia, come here. Oh, I got everybody. Good girl. Noodle, Rich. Good boy.